Good evening, boomer nerds and friends, wherever you are and whenever you are. This is the boomer nerd, and we're going back to normal programming, and we're going to try and update our data. Today is currently the 15th of March. So given that we've got that time and it's been a few days since I've updated the data, let's get busy and start playing with it and see what we can bring up. Okay, so I'm going to refresh the data page. I don't expect it to give us too much in the way of new information. This is rather interesting. Italy seems to be flying up the charts. It's now the second highest outside of China. And as part of my exercise today, I'm going to create a forecast which will allow us to try and determine to some degree when it will overrun China's numbers. Of course, we know that we don't believe China's numbers, but still, it's just going to be an interesting mental exercise. It seems that Iran hasn't shot up quite as quick. I'm not sure why. Either they don't have the capabilities or maybe they're hiding as well. Same with South Korea. Notice a lot of these other nations are starting to get up into the high hundreds and the low thousands. That phone is giving me the shits. I'm going to pause this and I'm going to come back in a moment. Okay. Got rid of that stupid phone. It just keeps begging for attention, and I have better things to do than to worry about trying to give a stupid phone attention. If someone happens to ring up too bad, it will just have to ring out. Okay, so we're at the stage where we're just looking at the latest figures. So you can see we're up to around about 156,000. Now I created a spreadsheet, and in that I wanted to anticipate what the numbers were going to be like out. That's the global figures there. All right, let's go back and take a quick look. Okay, so this is the global figures here, including China. Now at that time I said a forecast was supposed to be by the 12th 152,000, supposed to be going up 20% per day, and as we can see, that has not happened. 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, so I said we should have been up to 263,000. So that was using figures of global including China. Now if we look at figures not including China, it would be 95,000. But then if we add the figures for China of about 80,000, that would put us at 175,000. Is that right? Yeah, 175,000. Because China stayed fairly static, even though we don't necessarily believe their figures. We'll just take the figures that they give us and we'll run with those. So they're saying that they're staying around about the 80,000 mark. Let's take a quick look. Just run up here. Is there 81,000 just there? So I'm still off by about 10,000 or so. That's fine. It was only a forecast, so it's an educated guess, which was based on a increase rate. And here it is. This is a graph which was looking at the percentage increase without China. And as we noted at that time, we'd gone up to about 20% per day. So we're going to take a look at all of these and update them accordingly. So let's go off and get the numbers again and get ourselves some updates. Okay, I've lost all my pages, so we'll go down to the bottom here, and yeah, that's the right spot. We'll just open up in a new tab. Okay, so we want the data, we want the time series, We're going to grab the confirmed data first, then the deaths, then the recovered. Okay, so we want the raw numbers. We're going to save it, but I don't want to save it in there. I want to save it under Corona 2020. So we're just going to save and clobber. Then we're going to back up by two. One more. Oh, this is annoying. Now I have to refresh the page. There we go. Okay, so go in. And we're going to be flying tonight. I'm not going to be holding too much back. Otherwise, okay, back one, back two. We will now refresh to get the data we want. Don't know why it's doing that. It seems rather strange, but anyway. And because it's so strange, it's really a waste of time. Okay. So now we've updated the data, I'll just blow that tab away. A lot of these others I don't really need. I might blow them away at some other stage. Okay. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to check how many rows do we have. So we've got to go up here, make sure we've got the same number of rows. Right now, we're up to 405 rows, so we'll just check once we open up the confirmed. So we're on the confirmed tab there. All of them will have the same rows. All three files will have the same number of rows, so that's no big deal. Okay, I'm just going to go here, control down to the bottom. No, we've pumped up the number of rows again. So we're up to 443 rows. And they are breaking down further regions. So occupied Palestinian territory, it's got zero. Is there any other zeros up here? Yep, there's a whole stack of zeros here. Now, what's that in favour of? Why have we got things here with zeros? What's going on? Okay, I'll have to investigate that in a moment. So we're up to the 14th. The latest figures we had were 3 days ago. On the 11th, okay. Now. That's given me an idea. Okay. I want to go into the zeros. Look up those zeros. And see what, okay. Oh, I see what they've done. They're trying to break down the US into finer regions, so they're breaking them down into counties. Now, personally, I myself do not care too much about the counties. If they really care so much about the counties, then at some stage they'll probably add another column, which would include the county. Let's just have a look. Province/state. Yeah. I like the simplicity of Australia. We've got, about six states, three territories. And that's pretty much it for us. And, of course, a big chunk of the, the Antarctic. Okay, well, we're going to have to make some adjustments to the data. Well, especially to the spreadsheet. What I'm going to do is instead of moving this row down like I did last time, I'm going to move this row down by one. So right now it says it's a sum up to 405. I want to see what impact it has when I just insert a row above, and it says sum up to 406. Good. That's the impact I want. What it means is as I push this down, I do not have to worry about these sums. These sums will automatically adjust themselves. I will not have to do anything extra with them. So that's most helpful. What I'll do now is we're up to 408, and I've got to go down to, what did we have to go back down to before? 443. Okay, so let's do that. We'll go up down to 440. There it is. So we'll do an insert rows above. So it's moved everything down. The only thing it hasn't moved down is all of our dang graphs. And that is so freaking annoying. But anyway, we'll pull the graphs down now. So we'll put that one down there. Okay, beautiful. Take it in a little bit and then we can see exactly. Confirmed infections Australia, confirmed infections Japan. Don't know why I put Japan, I think it was just for a matter of comparison to see whether or not it was running up. If anyone is interested in me doing some numbers on other countries, give me a hoy. We might be able to organise something. Okay, down, oh, there we go. Stop there. Right, okay, so we can't go any lower than that. Well, don't run away on me like that. Okay. Oh, and it's running off again on me. Don't do that to me. There we go. Make sure I'm not clobbering or sitting on the top of dates. Bit further. Yep, that's okay. This is so boring. I wish there was a quicker way of doing this. I wonder if record macros might help me to do it. Okay, so now we've got a big gap. We really need to insert another row. There we go. Now we're at 443 rows. And let's double check this. E2 to E443. Yes. Okay, that's what I want. Okay, so that saved me a whole stack of work with formula adjustments. So let's grab it all. So we're going to go Control Home. Yeah, that works. Okay, just double check and make sure we're all good. Okay, looks good. Come on. Yep, that's what we want. So now, oops. Yep, okay, here we go. Control Home takes me straight to A1. We're going to clobber everything and add in some more cells. Now, at this point in time, just as a matter of curiosity, I want to see what we're out to. Last time we were out B, now we're out to BE. So let's go down to 443. And we're going to be clobbering some of this stuff. How do you like that? Okay, so I'm just going to grab these two cells here. Run them out to here. Don't need to do that. Yes, want to clobber. Good. Okay. This here doesn't need to be adjusted too much. At least not yet. We'll come back to that later. What we'll do in the meantime is we'll just continue to add the extra cell data. So we'll do the same here. BE. Yes, done. Okay. So all we're doing is just adding another three columns into the data that's already there. Okay. Now, if you want to see how I do a lot of this data, you might want to learn how it all is done. Take a look at my first few videos, which will explain in detail some of the logic behind what I'm doing. If there's anything you don't understand and you want to understand exactly what I'm trying to do, then by all means fire me off a question if I find it of sufficient interest. Hang on, what happened there? Did that? No, nothing happened. Okay. All right, I'll just have to. I don't know what I did there. Hit some keys, good old fumble fingers. Okay, let's move this across. Oh, this is interesting. This is the one that's giving the rate of increase per day. Oh, look at that. It was 5.9% on this day, jumped up to 35.5% another day, and then it's come back down to 17% on the 14th. So as you can see, it's jumping around a little bit. In a moment, I'm really tempted to hit that one first, because to me that's the most interesting one, because that's the one that we're going to use to give us a bit of a forecast. What I'm very tempted to do is try and find a way to try and smooth out the data. I'll have to do some statistics research to see if there's a way if I can smooth out the line. And if we can smooth out the line, we can probably get some kind of sensible idea within reason as to what we can expect in terms of a forecast. But I'll take a look at the line itself and come to a judgment of my own, maybe an eyeball of the line. Okay, I think that's about as far as we can go at the moment. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to just quickly update all of these. So going from BB to BE in all of our ranges. Here we go. This is going to look interesting. Look how the curve is curving up there. So let's go in and adjust the data. So I double click on this blue line. All right. Even double clicking doesn't always seem to do what I want. So we're going to go data ranges. Okay, BB. So it's going to be BE. And this one. BE. Oh, look at that. Nice little bit of a jump. But if you follow the line trend, you'll notice it went flattened out and then it jumped back up to its normal curvature. If you smooth the curve out, you would probably notice that it would. Well, I wish I could draw all up. I could draw over the top of that. It'd be nice. I could illustrate exactly what I'm doing. But just run a line, a slight curve line straight up there, and you'll probably notice that the curve doesn't really change that much as you go from this point up to here. And we're probably going to see the same jump in the next graph that we go to. So we're going to go down here. We're going to update this line as well. Now, the other day I said this line was a beautiful line, mathematically speaking. But real life has a way of messing with your beautiful lines. Anyway, let's go in here. We'll go E and E. And okay, look at that. See how it messed up there? It could be that there are people taking their time getting their new figures in, so they just had left them with the old figures and assumed that the figures were staying the same. But once again, you've got a mess in that particular line, and it's jumped up to there. So a smoothed out curve would show it that it's still on the geometric trend. Okay, now confirmed infection in South Korea. This is where I'm getting a bit sus, this one. Okay, so we'll go in here. Okay, so we'll change the data ranges here. We'll update them. So click on that one. So we go with BE, and BE. See how that's flattening out. I'm really suspicious of that. I reckon that they, being an Asian country who has a very similar culture to China, are probably finding a similar kind of embarrassment. By the way, I'm taking my headphones off for the time being. All they're doing is warming up my ears and is not giving me any indication as to how loud I'm coming back. I have to rely on the VU meter bar to tell me, and at the moment it's telling me it's jumping up into the red. All right, we're going to continue on to Iran, which is the other country of interest. And we're just going to put in the new data ranges. There we go. So let's go B, E, and we want B, E here. Well, that's interesting. I thought Iran could have. And I'll show you why. Let's suppose we've got this day divided by we'll just keep pushing along. Okay. I've got the wrong bracket in there as well. That doesn't help. Divided by this day minus this day, and then we press enter and it says 11. See, that can't be right. We want to see 0.1. Or roughly about that kind of number. So why are we getting we should be seeing let's see what we can do here. So we'll subtract that from that, and then we divide by that, and then we get 0.1. So let's take a look at the formula and see what we've got. Okay, so we need to be putting, let's fix that up. So the formula should be divided by day, x is that right, or is it x minus 1? I think it's x minus 1. Day x minus day divided by day x minus 1, that works better. Okay. What's going on here? Suddenly saw my screen drop out.